This year in First Portadown, we are celebrating 200 years of ministry and mission in Edenderry and further afield. And we recognise that we are totally dependent upon the Lord. And Jesus said, without me, you can do nothing. In this video, we want to reflect on what it means to be a flourishing and fruitful church. And we want to encourage you to look forward as we seek to be a blessing to those around us in the society and community in which God has placed us.
How does the church encourage our young people to flourish? I think as a church, we have two main points of focus. The first point is that we want to see all of our young people coming to a saving faith in Jesus. We want them to know Jesus as their own personal Lord and Savior. And then secondly, as a church, we want to take that young faith and we want to nurture it into one of depth and resilience so that they have that resilient faith as they go to face a godless world.
I just think that church is so good for helping young people flourish, particularly because it's such a safe place for YF and CE to happen. I love how individual families just come together as one and chat to us and pray for us. I think that's so important in growing in not only my faith but the relationships with other people. I've also seen in the past few years as my dad has came to faith how everybody's just came together to help him and help us as a family, and I've just found that really encouraging. So I have enjoyed growing up in this church and flourishing in my own faith and the relationships with people.
I think the church provides a range of organisations for young people to attend. There's lots of choice, for example, BB, Brownies, CE, YF and Bible class. In these organisations, there's plenty of time to socialise, build relationships and to grow in your Christian faith. The leaders are good role models and are always willing to answer any questions, helping young people to flourish.
As a young member of the church, there are many opportunities to be involved in CE mission teams. I've been personally blessed and encouraged by my experience in Malahide this year. It's really helped me strengthen and grow in my faith, and it's helped me learn how to serve others.
A flourishing church supports Christians of all ages to develop their faith. At First Portadown, we provide opportunities for growing in faith together through prayer groups and fellowship groups, as we share together and encourage each other. Growing in faith together also happens as we develop friendships and relationships within our church community. However, we know that we are not there yet. We need to be more intentional about encouraging Christians of all ages to grow in their faith, from the youngest to the oldest, as we walk together on this lifelong journey.
I think we need to remember that God's plan for mission happens through us, the members of the church. We are His hands and His feet. He asks us to be obedient, to expand His kingdom by going to people around us and sharing His good news and His love with whoever we might come into contact with. And I think we might be surprised sometimes who that is. Might be people who we wouldn't normally spend time with or wouldn't normally want to speak to, but they're people right on our doorstep that God's asking us to go and share His love with.
And it might feel like that stepping out of your comfort zone, or a bit intimidating or a bit scary to do that, something that you've not done before. But actually when we do choose to be courageous and bold, because we have this really good news to share with people, this hope that we can share with those around us, and if we are bold in doing that, you end up getting to work with God. And He might already be doing something in someone and you get to partner with Him in that, and that is always really exciting and it's amazing to see what God can do.
Here at First Portadown, we are really blessed with so many talented musicians. The Lord has put in our congregation so many musically gifted people. Between our musicians and our singers, they work so well together in harmony. And I think it's lovely as a congregation that we sing together with our kids before they leave the service as well. Sometimes as believers, we can underestimate the importance of worship. It's not just that we're coming to church on a Sunday to sing because it's what we've always done, but God's word tells us to sing to Him numerous times. It's really important. It brings together a sense of unity. It makes us thankful. It makes us humble. And most importantly, it prepares us for God's word.
The best known answer in the Shorter Catechism is, man's chief end is to glorify God and enjoy Him forever. True worship leads to genuine joy. Here in First Portadown, centered on God's Word, we meet each Sunday for worship. And the people gather bringing their gifts of music, of song, of prayer, of practical helps and money. Each of these are an element of self-sacrifice, of worship to the God who loved us so much that He sent His Son to be our Savior, to give Himself so that we could truly live.
The challenge for the church in the 21st century is to continue to communicate the unchanging message of the gospel to an increasingly secular society. We can no longer assume that people will simply turn up to church on a Sunday, nor can we assume that they know the message of the gospel as it's revealed in the Bible. And so the challenge for us is to get the good news of the gospel out to the society in which we live, to tell people that Jesus loves them, that He can forgive their sins and give them hope and peace and eternal life. And as a church, we need to flourish. The prophet Micah said that as God's followers, we must love mercy and do justice and walk humbly with our God. Jesus Himself said that we are to be salt and light in this world. And that means we are to have a positive impact upon the community in which we live. We can't change human hearts. We can't change our own hearts. We're fallen sinners before a holy God. But we know the person who can change lives and hearts. And He has said, "I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it."